Alright, in our first match here, we have Bean Boy from Helias versus Gizmo from Linn High School. Kazuya versus Minmin on FD. Now, generally, FD is Kazuya's best stage and seen as a big advantage for Kazuya. Against Minmin, however, I think this is actually one of, if not Kazuya's worst matchup. So I don't know. This stage might be better for Minmin, just given that there's no platform, she can really space Kazuya out. Even easier on the stage. Kazuya has nowhere else to go. But we'll see if Matthew can get in, get this rage drive off, and take this first stock. The neutral air going to come through. Not quite killing yet. Matthew getting some good damage on. Not going to kill yet. Nice avoiding the dragon. Dragon beam. I don't actually know what it's called. Take it. And just the straight up forward smash to see that first stock. Looks like we have a little bit of lag. This Minmin player is just running away, which I guess is kind of what you gotta do against Kazuya in some cases. Very scary character. As soon as Matthew gets in here, gotta rip and tear. Stage now. Nice, avoiding the ram. Back on stage now. The Minmin smash is coming through though. Getting the rage drive, very nice damage on board. The dragon uppercut not quite hitting. Going for another one. That is going to steal the second stock. Nice parry. Ooh, the forward smash just missing. Nice spot dodge from Gizmo. Going for the edge guard, not quite getting it. Gizmo's gonna run back to stage. Some lag. This looks abysmal to play against. The first matches are always blind picks, so I guess we just got an unlucky bad matchup to start off with. Because this looks so hard as Kazuya. But if there's anyone who can get the stock off, it's Matthew. Bean Boy 128. Not quite gonna get that one. And the Minmin steals that stock. into this next game, we've got Lucas Omega on Incineroar versus Gizmo, once again on the Min Min. He's going to have to SD1 before we start this match because Bean Boy was able to take a stock off him last time, even in that abysmal matchup. But we're getting right into this one, into the action of the second game. Is Lucas going to be able to take this one out, or is Gizmo going to take another stock for his team? Min Min is tough to fight, especially if you have a little bit of lag online. Oh, but that is going to be lag working in our favor, I guess, there. Unfortunate buffered air dodge, SD, I'd assume. Gizmo has tacked on about 70% on Lucas, but Lucas striking right back, getting nearly 40% on Gizmo. You take this Min Min down, 50% now. Gizmo's gotta be careful with getting back. Incineroar can just kill you sometimes. Especially if he gets a good advantage state. Lucas getting right back in. Now 70% on him. Is he gonna take this one out? The up air. No jump on Gizmo, but he makes it back to ledge. Ooh, and the up air. Or sorry, the up B gonna hit him. He's gotta get off stage, get off ledge again. Decided to be not quite gonna connect. It's intense. This next stock's important who takes it. Gonna either even up the game or earn a bigger lead for their team. Just gonna make it back to the stage, but unfortunately getting hit by the Min Min smash attack. Mega Watt. We're just gonna steal a stock out real soon here. Gonna get the jab instead. Resetting neutral. Gizmo's gotta watch out now. He wants to avoid being killed. Incineroar can just kill you. This matchup looks so hard as Incineroar. Because you're... The only kind of speed Incineroar has is up and down, and that's not the most helpful against Min Min. No horizontal speed on this character. But, oh, no side B there either. Nice recovery, making it back. Jump though, you gotta watch out. Nice using this super armor to get through the smash attack. But the Megawatt gonna come through and take that stock as well, actually. And Gizmo has earned a good lead for his team. So Lucas Omega gonna be able to close this one out. Need one big hit, but that's the scary thing as well. Against Min Min, if you get gimped off stages in Incineroar, that can just be it. Let's see. Lucas can get in and take this one down. Megawatt gonna come through again. Now both players at kill percent. This is getting scary. The up smash is gonna seal out that game for Gizmo.
Thank you.
All right, we have Orb of Light versus Gizmo. PS2 is definitely a good stage to deal with some of these attacks. It's a lot harder when you're on stages like Final Destination. Definitely gotta play a very careful game to get around Min-Min's attacks. It's very easy to get the high percentages, very easy. A lot of people tend to play Min-Min in a very campy style, because it tends to get the most damage. Ooh, and she pulled out the hard-hitting arm. You know, I never see a lot of people pull out the dragon arm. I feel like they should use all of them except, but I guess not. Ooh, and Orb loses the stock. Definitely gotta do your best to play around the arms. It's very difficult. Ooh, and he hits a grab. Oh! Nearly kills Orb with that one. Ooh, will that stop from recovering? Ooh, that might be the one. Ooh, and Orb wins.
No hesitation. Thank you.
All right, now we have Orb of Light versus Flaming Manguin. So they're playing Sephiroth. Definitely got to watch out for that sword. I think it's called the Masamune. Ooh, tried to go for that. Easy to shield to that one. Ooh, that reflector. That's a doozy. Unless you hit it with just enough power. I gotta say, I do love hitting that reflector whenever I'm at full power with Incineroar, because then it just destroys it. Ooh, and sadly, Flaming Manguin loses a stock like that. Really, this is a battle of range against range. Spyloth does have that kind of range, too. I wonder when Sephiroth's wing is going to kick in. Ooh, and sadly Flaming Manguin loses another stock to falling. Trying his best to be on the defensive. Ooh, nearly broke the shield right there. If he hit the sweet spot, that would have been done for Orb. For those who don't know, the sweet spot would have been the tip of the sword. Very close right now. Ooh, nearly hitting Orb. Ooh, and he missed that. Getting very close. Who knows what could happen next? Ooh, oh, and Orb nearly loses his stock, but not just yet. Orb is fighting for his life right now. And Orb wins.
Each battle, a chance to grow.
All right, up next, Linn is sending in Peyton is Gaming YT. Now we have Orb of Light versus Peyton is Gaming YT.
3, 2, 1, go!
Alright, let's see how Orb of Light can do this. Ganondorf's heavy hitting attacks are definitely dangerous to deal with. Especially that up smash. Ooh, they had a clank. Honestly, I'm always terrified when I have a clank, but that's just because I play close range. Orb definitely playing very defensively right now. Ooh, and he wasn't able to make it back to ledge. Ooh, and a forward smash takes out Orb. That lag is definitely an issue. It's pretty hard to deal with. And then he hits the side B. Trying to keep center stage is very important right now. Ooh, will he keep the juggle going? Ooh, and he keeps the juggle going. Peyton at a very high percentage. Ooh, and he snipes him! Be anyone's game now. Ooh, and he hits that with the down tilt, which to my knowledge is true. Ooh, and he waits out the arrow. Ooh, he nearly falls. This is very close right now. Ooh. Can he hit the juggle? Oh, this is very close. Just gotta play very defensively right now. Ooh, and Orb wins this one.
Chance to grow.
All right, now we have Orb versus Desert Kiwi.
3, 2, 1, go!
See how Orb manages with one stock. That one's a little scary. I can see LHS shaking in the boots.
Fail not!
Plan very carefully, trying to make sure that Desert doesn't lose a stock. I see now. So it would put him at quite a disadvantage if they were to lose a stock. See, will Orb be able to take out one of the stocks? Or maybe two or three. You never know. Ooh, now Prontoplant has his poison gas fully charged. Orb's gonna have to play very carefully if he wants to get a kill off of him. Ooh. Prontoplant has a lot of heavy hidden attacks. Gotta be very careful. Ooh, and he hits the arrow. Ooh, getting really close. Ooh, and Orb loses. All right, now we have Ingrid Fanboy versus Desert Kiwi. Bowser matchup is definitely scary. Kiwi really likes that spike ball. Big fan of it. I would even say a fanatic. Desert Kiwi is like. Desert Kiwi really loves that spike ball. Wow. Wonder what Kiwi's gonna do next. I bet it's spike ball. And it's spike ball. Nothing like a little more spike ball. Is he gonna do spike ball? Ooh, spike ball. And another spike ball. What's gonna happen next? Is it gonna be a spike ball? And it's another spike ball. Ooh, nearly, like, Ingrid Fanboy absolutely eradicated him. I'm surprised that wasn't a spike ball. All right, we have K-Cool versus Desert Kiwi. Thank you. And another spike ball. What's Kiwi gonna do next? I bet it's a spike ball. That was a spike ball. That was a spike ball. And Kiwi throws out another spike ball. What's that? Oh, spike ball. Let's see, what's it? Oh, and it's another spike ball. And that's another spike ball. Wonder what Kiwi's gonna do next. Is it a spike ball? It is. My bet is yes.
Alright, now getting into our second set here versus Linn High School, we have K Cool on Corrin versus Flaming Manguin on Sephiroth. And we're gonna get right into the battling here as this is the beginning of a new set, so no one's gonna have to SD. Flaming Manguin getting a counter, but this is still quite an even game so far. Cool landing. Landing with the down air, getting some nice damage on Flaming Manguin. and are not quite going to connect that time. But avoiding the up airs very well. Looking for some up airs of his own. Claiming Mangwin to be able to dodge and weave out of them. The side B stalling, but starts back with the side B of his own, and the counter comes through. Getting nice getting 60% now, and 90% on K-Cool. Which is now 100. And this is starting to get scary versus Sephiroth. Uses the counter to avoid getting hit by the Skittles. Very nice. And he's going to get the dash attack. And Mangwin's in disadvantage here now. How is K-Cool going to punish this? Goes for the side B, doesn't quite connect though. But Flaming Mangwin's only going to punch with the jab. The dash attack coming through, not quite killing yet. K-Cool holding onto the stock. Nice job dodging over the neutral B with the high recovery. But that dash attack is going to seal that first stock out. And getting the forward smash? Oh no, but the forward smash doesn't connect, unfortunately. Getting the neutral B. Flaming Mangwin's now at 100%, but that counter is 50% almost. Neutral B coming through. The down smash hitting, not quite killing. Michael Kling did a good job dodging the neutral B with using his side B for momentum. The up B to dodge again, but the up smash is going to come through this time from Flaming Mangwin. And getting the nice side B, striking right back with the kill is K-Cool. Percent-wise, we are at an even game now. Both players tacking on about 50%. Very even game. K-Cool. K-Cool landing with the down air. Not going to get the punish on the up B. Going to counter the neutral B. Dash attack coming through for Flaming Mangwin, though. But he's going to miss the down smash. The forward smash. K-Cool getting the dash attack. And going to get the forward smash. Let's go, K-Cool. And making this an even game stock-wise now. Gotta watch out, though. Sephiroth can kill you around these percents. Especially now that you're 100. One more up air above that top platform might do it. Nice job avoiding this up B, but going to get hit by the up tilt instead. Up air coming through again. Oh, the up smash. Barely avoiding it with the down air, but getting that hit. Pickle doing very well here. Not hitting the counter. Getting a forward smash. I'm going to let it go too late on that one, not getting the full damage. Oh! Oh! Oh, wait! He's dead! He's dead! And K-Cool clutches the game! Let's go! Right here into the second game. Got K Cool. He's gonna have to SD twice at the start. Only, but keeping one stock in the last game, winning the first game for his team. And then Peyton is gaming here for Linn. On Captain Falcon, last time he was on Ganondorf. Switching it up this time. And we're gonna get right into the action. Peyton running in, up smashing to up air, dealing almost 40%. Now it is 40% with that dash attack. Falcon can deal some serious damage. The speed is hard to get around as well. Force smash coming through. Kiko's gonna watch out at 100% now. Kiko's gonna strike back at this one. Gets the side B into the upper. Oh, but the up B not quite gonna connect in full. Unfortunately, Korn is a mid tier, but that up B is gonna connect. Going for the side B, not quite landing it, but avoiding his attack as well. Getting the side B. Oh, going for the upper, doesn't quite land. Gonna watch out now. Dodging the up smash. Scared of this kill from Peyton is gaming. Is Keiko gonna take this stock first? Very well could. Side B coming through with 87%. Not quite gonna get the forward smash. Peyton is gaming, looking for some strong hits now. Doesn't go get the up smash. The down air gonna get the landing hitbox. The up B gonna connect. Not quite gonna kill. Goes for the other up B. Not quite gonna hit. But the up smash is gonna miss as well. This is so intense. Oh, and the dash tech is gonna seal that first game. Very close stock though. Very good for both players. Now, even game, 12 stocks to 12 stocks. We're sending in Lucas Omega on Incineroar versus Peyton is gaming on Captain Falcon. No one's going to SD as this is a completely even game. Both pairs at 3 stocks. He's going to take this one. Lucas Omega starting off with the back air. Not quite going to get the side B though. Peyton going in, trying to get an edge guard. Doesn't get it though. Lucas being very aware of that recovery. Avoiding the up smash. Going for a dash attack. Not quite going to connect. But spot dodging the side B. Very nice. Get a side B of his own. 69%. Forwarder coming through. Looking for a side B. Doesn't quite get it though. Forward smash doesn't quite connect. Now, this is a very scary percent to be at if your Peyton is gaming. And Lucas will kill you. The up B gonna hit him while recovering back to stage. Anything's gonna take the stock here. Both players at very much a kill percent now. Looking for force smash, doesn't quite connect though. Side B does quite land. But getting the back throw, not quite gonna kill. Almost though. Getting the side B, and that will definitely kill. That move is very strong, and especially at 150%, there's no hope of getting back from that. Getting the counter to dash attack to deal nearly 40%. Using neutral B to get out of Captain Falcon's side B. Now Peyton's already got to be afraid again of getting killed once again. But he's going to land a down B of his own and take that first stock. Lucas has built up a good percent lead. He'll be able to keep it. Force smash, not quite trying to connect. Peyton just running in and attacking him. Incineroar. Sometimes that's what you gotta do, but if you're not careful, Incineroar can very much take advantage of that. Neutral will be coming through. Getting the revenge, and the dash attack gonna kill super hard off that top blast zone. Down through a forward air. Nice combo, but the combo's gonna be interrupted with Hacking Falcon's side B. That move does have a bit of super armor, though super armor, it works a bit jankily. For the side B, doesn't quite connect. Forward smash missing. Grab not quite coming through. Down smash gonna hit. Looks like Mega High's gonna make it back to stage now. Makes it right back. Goes for an up smash, doesn't quite connect. Down B coming through. Gonna go for a downer. Peyton's not gonna land it though. High percent. This game has a lot more lag than previous ones. The dash attack coming through. Not quite gonna kill yet. Luka's still alive. Incineroar with Rage is scary. And he counters the up smash. This could be it if Peyton doesn't get it. But Peyton gets that second stock now. We have a dead even stock game. Luka's with a 42% lead though. The forward tilt coming through. Now at 60%. Peyton's gonna dodge the side B. Luka's looking against Pitson. Looking for another side B. Doesn't quite connect. Both players looking for the side B there, actually. Going for the up smash. Quite gonna get it. Going for down B combos. Not gonna land. Side B gonna connect. That's not quite gonna be it, though. One more will do it. And that Nair offstage will definitely do it. Very nicely done from Lucas. Alright, into the next game, we have Gizmo on Incineroar versus Lucas Omega, Lucas Omega on Incineroar versus Gizmo on the Min-Min. So Min-Min was a problem last game. Lucas gonna have to SD twice. We have a one stock lead right now. Who's gonna be able to steal out these stocks? FD, probably being Min-Min's best stage. Is Lucas gonna be able to get in and take this one out? It's gonna be really hard to approach Min-Min here. If anyone's gonna get in, it's gonna be Lucas. Smash text coming in from Min-Min. Nearly 60%, now 70%. How do you approach this? Getting the back throw to send Min-Min off stage into a ledge trap situation. Not quite getting the forward air. The revenge not quite gonna land. Gizmo getting the Mega Watt neutral B. That is going to be an unfortunate SD at the end there.
Use your fire.
All right, we have Orb of Light versus Gizmo.
3, 2, 1, go!
Gotta play very careful. It's good that they have the platform. What? Ooh, and Orb takes the first stock. Definitely gotta play very carefully against Moomin. That quick arm could easily keep you off stage. Ooh, Orb's got his limit. Will Orb hit his limit? Ooh, and Orb missed the limit. Ooh. Ooh, is that enough to keep her away? And it is! Gizmo's gonna have to play really hard to get this back. Trying to hit that. A really hard hitting arm. I don't know, man. Ooh! And Orb hits it! All right, now we have Orb of Light versus Holly Rocker. See how Orb manages. Ooh, an Orb takes the first stock. Nice. Oh yeah, you never want to mess with Cloud during the shield. I've hit Cloud while he shielded many times and got my world rocked by his uppy. Ooh, and Orb takes another stock. He's doing good with those limit attacks. All Orb's gotta do is build up his limit. Ooh, an Orb spikes him. Nice.
We are back with Orb of Light versus Desert Kiwi. Interesting pick on Piranha Plant. It's a not very played character, potentially for good reason, but there's a lot of nuances to this matchup. A lot of projectiles could be coming Orb of Light's way. Not careful. Tactic. Those are cute. Very close management. Potential will be devastating if it can't cover. But a lot of it's up to intuition and luck on those kind of edge cards. Interesting trade. Overblight is not working. Good block, Desert Kiwi. Element break on cloud could be deadly if not dealt with. That is the first stock taken by Orb of Light. So far, it's still looking to be a very even game. Down smash, that's pretty easy. Very good. Limit break. Close to even. Does your Kiwi still one stock up? Pretty much dead even now. Super armor on that. A lot of spike balls coming from Does your Kiwi. Very zoner type character played in this way. The break. Ooh, that is the last stock of Orb of Light taken.
A run of life. Win.
Now getting into this game, we have Beanboy 128 on Sephiroth and Desert Kiwi on Piranha Plant. Just gonna lose one and then we're gonna get right into the action. Piranha Plant is a bizarre matchup. Let's see what Beanboy can do here. Gonna get the upbeat on stage, dealing 30%. Kiwi just going to be using a lot of dash attack and Kiwi here, so it looks like. The neutral B? Can you get it? The other neutral B not going to connect though. There's a Kiwi looking for the dash attack, looking for the down B, not going to get it. Looking for the fully charged neutral B on stage into the mid charge. Mid charge not going to connect though. Sui just going to miss to the Hell's Gate. Ooh. Oh no! It's gonna be an unfortunate SD from Beanboy. The Desert Kiwi at a very high percent here. Almost any hit can kill him. And that, is that going to do it? Not quite going to do it. Piranha Plant actually being on the heavier side of characters in this game. And he's not quite going to do it either. Forward air, still not going to take it. Piranha Plant's heavy. Getting the side B on him. Side B is actually just gonna kill. Desert Kiwi with almost 100% on B-Boy here. Gotta be really careful. Piranha Plant has some surprisingly strong moves. The 2E gonna connect, doing a bit of damage. So Kiwi goes for the dash tech, and he's gonna land the forward smash. Gonna get the counter. Very nice. Down smash. Side B not quite gonna connect. Or sorry, neutral B not quite gonna connect. Hits the back air. Desert Kiwi gonna escape here. And that neutral B not quite gonna seal out the stock. This is Desert Kiwi's last stock. And the last stock of his team's life, and the crew battle, and Bean Boy seals it out. Very nicely done.
Chevron.